BBC News reports Tupac Shakur, found alive and well in Serbia, reunites the fractured Yugoslav state. Finally, Tupac has come to his real calling. It was actually to reform the greatest empire of all, Yugoslavia, in 2001. Wait, this is exactly 2 days after... Respondents were asked to identify Persia on the map. So this is kind of a spin-off of a very famous post asking Americans to figure out where Iran was on a map. Less than a quarter were able to figure it out exactly. Some even pointed to the USA itself. Wait, to be fair, is there a city in the USA called Iran? Okay, there is not. Well, I tried to help you guys out. But this is actually a map where Iran has their old ancient Persian borders. As you can see, it's going all the way through North Africa, even a little bit into Greece. So in this new alt history, we have 31% of Americans choosing the right location, a bit better. Although it is a lot easier to point to since the borders are just a lot more massive. Still, never can count us out, Americans. There's still gonna be some that pick randomly the ocean right here. Cooperation is key. Our Soviet friends are already working with an American colleague in many different fields, such as science, trade, peacekeeping, and many more. Meanwhile, many American citizens are living in the Soviet Union and working side by side with their new comrades. Join them today. Contact the nearest Department of State office to learn more about our exchange programs available to you. This is clearly an alt history where the Soviet Union did not fall, and we are somewhere in the future. Some sort of very strange dystopian future. I don't trust whatever's going on here. Ah, now here we go. A government website for the Empire of Germany if they won World War I. And clearly this website was built in like 2003, and they have never once updated it. Like in that domain name, deutschland.de. Discover Germany. Learn about the states. Oh, gotta love those old Imperial German borders, though. Meet Kaiser Frederick IV. What a lineage he has. The Reichstag votes to extend 500 billion mark loan to Berlin-Baghdad Railroad Company. And they misspelled it. Very nice. Very professional of you. German military band prepares for things. Oh, like they're wearing the helmets. Bismarck Hindenburg Airport sees the Hindenburg Airport. I feel like that's kind of a bad omen. But that happened in 1937. Maybe it didn't crash and burn in this alt history. A YouTube video in another timeline by Potential History. The colonies could not win the Revolutionary War. And it seems like most people agree, how could those dumb American farmers beat the greatest British military of all time? Ooh, but take a look at some of these suggested videos in the tab below. How Britain won the Revolutionary War. Thanks, History Channel. The only thing unrealistic about this is I don't see any aliens in the thumbnail. Or maybe the History Channel doesn't suck in this universe. And then we also have What If Alt History with his own take of how the colonies could have won. I agree with this comment. This guy's totally right. 1 in 12 demons will be subjugated to forced exorcism during their labor contract. Can you imagine? Forced exorcism? That's a violation of the right to bargain. Good thing we have this demons watch group to protect these people. See, in the US, we kind of have mixed opinions. Some states allow it, some states don't. But countries in Western Europe, Canada, and a lot in Asia really trying to abolish this act. It's just so terrible. I can see the Vatican is not a fan, though. There's a small dot in Italy. The only thing unrealistic about this map is I've never seen gray represented by anything else but no data. Oh man, I'm just glad North Korea's taking the right side on this. A Wikipedia page describing the 1981 Gotham City riots. Oh, it happened on Halloween night or around there. Wait, Gotham is in New Jersey? Ew. Of course, it was caused by the 81 subway shooting. And this great TV show, Murray, did not make it through. The US government and the government of New Jersey tried to stop the rioters and looters, but unfortunately that was not enough. Can you imagine the property damage that was also caused during this event? You're laughing. My favorite late night comedian was shot live and you're laughing. Restore the glory of the lost. Retake the West Coast. Now I'm really confused about whatever happened in this alternative timeline. Why am I getting Imperial Japanese vibes? But that's from the East Coast. If Imperial Japan did take over the US, they would be taking over the Pacific states. I'm just really confused. Is this like a weird timeline where like Germany and Japan switched sides? The Republic of California, Cascadia. I don't really know what happened. Or is this some sort of like American Japanese puppet? Maybe this has nothing to do with Imperial Japan. I just feel like it does. Another government website, this time the Soviet Union in 2021. Again, I just love the old school vibes. Clearly a lot of these places are not updating their like UIs. This is reminding me of the old Wild West internet. I feel like I'm gonna get some sort of virus just by looking at this page. Greetings, comrade. The best and only place to find all government services and information. I also like that domain name, soviet.gov.ussr. So the Soviet Union weren't around, I'm assuming, long enough to create their own official website. I mean, the internet was around, and they were around till 1991. I just think it's probably too early. Did the Soviet Union have a website? I thought I'd Google that. .sus? .sus? That's really close. So this was the country code top-level domain. Ukraine given to them in September 1990, even though the Soviet Union itself was dissolved a mere 15 months later. I have to call it .sus. Okay, but I don't think they had an official website. Regardless, look at all this information you can get about the different republics. Loving the representation of all their flags? Got what it takes to serve the motherland? Join the KGB today! That sounds great. Fight the CIA and the FBI while they fight each other. Current waiting time for a driving permit, 61 weeks. Oh, not bad. COVID and the Soviet Union, that'd be an interesting combination. Yes, a beautiful map of the Haiti, or the, wait, that's not Haiti, the Hittite Empire, which of course is right next to Babylonian Puerto Rico, and is this Cuban Greece or something? Something that tells me these old civilizations just randomly put on the Caribbean would probably make them all a whole lot chiller. Like, who wants to, like, just completely brutalize a population when you have, like, beautiful water and coconuts around? I don't even know if they have coconuts in Haiti, but I'm gonna assume they do. There are about 1 million coconut trees in Haiti. All right. I really love these. More alt history YouTube channels, this time Geography Now, covering China with their correct flag. After this, I really gotta watch this What If Communist China Won alt history video. Can you imagine? I am very curious about how China reunited 70 years ago under this man, and how that small little island of Taiwan somehow just retained all the commies. That's one of my favorite things to think about. If somehow they did switch, does the People's Republic of China, the communists, go to Taiwan, and do they survive for very long? I'm assuming the USSR would guarantee their independence up until 1991, and then what happens to it? I mean, how easy would a democratic China be able to take over this island? I don't think it'd be very hard. I'm assuming the USA would be okay with that this time. Here, I present to you Small Denmark, or the smallest of all Denmarks. Kingdom of Denmark, which is only these little islands smashed in between Germany and Sweden. Would they even allow this? I'm pretty sure even Sweden would just decide to take them over at this point. So about 3.5 million people inhabit archipelago Legoland over here. Of course, they still speak Danish, and they're a constitutional monarchy. How many people actually live on these islands? I'm now for the first time ever curious. First of all, there are 5.8 million people as of 2020 in our Denmark. This is the first time ever I am learning that most people live on this island. I just assumed for my entire life that most people lived in the peninsula. There's actually a lot of other people out here. They wouldn't be cut down that much in terms of population if they lost this. This is called Jutland, by the way. I'm now figuring that out as well. And here's Denmark, each color containing 25% of the population. I don't know why. I just never expected anyone to live out on these islands. So I feel like you guys would still have pretty fun time being the Vikings, even if you just had this stuff. Yes, the second Emu War. It began January 2022. It was only 3 months, but it was a decisive Emu victory, formation of the Emu Empire, and the beginning of the Emu incursions into Indonesia. If the Australians couldn't stop them, then I know Indonesia has no chance. They were secretly supported by China, as well as the Commonwealth of Kiwis. That was really what probably set this thing over. Poor ScoMo, couldn't get a win there. It took minimal losses, and the other side was completely annihilated. An alternative World War I, where the alliances are completely flipped upside down. Well, not completely. We still have the UK and France on one side and Germany on the other, but their friends are a bit different. Austria-Hungary now joins the West, and then Spain and Turkey, who's not the Ottomans. Did they mean to do that, or is that an accident? So it would look something like this. It would definitely be interesting along this Franco-Spanish front, at least, considering France and Germany didn't have their borders move much. If Spain was attacking from the other side, I wonder what would happen. I mean, Spain wasn't really that strong at this time, so maybe nothing. But the big thing would be Russia would remain neutral, so Germany would not have to fight two fronts. It would just be France, really. But, well, they would, actually. That's right. I forgot about the big old Austro-Hungary. And what is Turkey really gonna do? I don't know. It all depends on what side the whole Italians choose. I've seen a lot of these posts for several years now. This time, 9 ways to divide the Republic of Texas. But this is a very different Republic of Texas. This isn't even the old, weird Republic of Texas borders. That's the strange thing. Like, at least give them this other strange panhandle that reaches all the way to Wyoming. But in this world, they have a lot of New Mexico, maybe even Arizona. Ethnicity is all over the place. A lot of Tejos? A lot of Tejanos, at least in the South. Doesn't seem to be very many rich politicians except in Dallas, perhaps, and then rich businessmen that are in all the other cities. Hazards would be all over the place, that's for sure, because they'd have to deal with tornadoes down here, hurricanes along the Gulf of Mexico. There's also the biggest disaster of them all, Americans. Okay, so this is an independent Texas free from Mexico as well. well, but they won a war against Mexico. So they won their independence and took land. Languages would be a very big cross between just Spanglish, but there's also some German creeping in. Oh, that's Boomhauer language. That's right. Sports would be a mess. Just Cowboys, Mavs, the Suns. Some socialists in there, perhaps, but both sides, of course, would have better food than the Americans. That's no doubt. A completely different internet if Latin America basically controlled the world. We have Jim Carrey playing Bolivar. I think Dragon Ball Z is identical, but Latin America does love Dragon Ball Z. Instead of the Titanic, we have the Hindenburg. Instead of Leo freezing, he's gonna burn. I'm sure there's some other things that are going over my head. Along with Latin American YouTube right here, front page is pretty much just controlled by, like, Spanish-speaking titles. Cone Markiplier E, Jacksepticeye. My trip to Pan-Asia was like, ooh, Jaden Animations. I love this one. So this is what the world probably looks like with this massive, strong Mexico. Ah, yes, this would probably be a much better Twitter, that's for sure. I'm gonna pretty much guarantee it would be way less sensitive of a place. I fully trust Jeb. He's the best man to lead us after his great victory in the midterms. He will stick it to the elites in Mexico City. Oh, and I like the stash. This is so, like, deep. The lore just keeps going. I love all the small references to what the world probably looks like. Ah, yes, imaginary maps showing what our world looks like. Why can't I live in this place? You ever just, like, see something and you're just like, I want to be here for, like, just a day. See what it's like. A future timeline where Canada is back, baby. Raise the maple leaf high. I guess in this universe, the U.S. advocated for a North American Union. So a combination of Canada, the U.S., and Mexico all as one massive country. And then a civil war broke out and they all fought for their independence. That did not work out too well for Mexico since they lost three pretty big states. But it did work out pretty good for Canada. Not only did they take Alaska, but also a pretty big chunk of Washington. For some reason, the U.S. like completely reorganized the Cascadian regions, which might have been the thing. If there was a huge North American Union, the 50 states might have kind of changed their borders. Oh yes, Wisconsin has the up. There we go. So Seattle is now part of the Cascadian Canadian province. Say that three times fast. Also, Canada somehow stole away Greenland, so they were probably briefly a part of the North American Union and then decided to join Canada. What's next for the former North American Union? Is this still the Union, kind of, but Canada's just independent? We're just gonna continue with these websites. Dixie.gov.cd. So CD would be their government domain. Why CD? Wouldn't it be like CS? Anyways, this is probably the best looking alt history website. If I'm gonna use any, it's probably gonna be this one. It's a lot more simpler, not all this crap in front of me. So obviously the South got pretty big victories. They took West Virginia, so Virginia's still big and thick. Oklahoma did lose their panhandle though, but they retained the southern part of Arizona and New Mexico. So you can explore the Confederacy. Oh wow, that's great. Secretary Warren's detailed recovery plan. What are they recovering from in the internet ages? Celebrating 160 years by Herman Cain. I'd really like to know a little bit deeper about what was going on at this time in this place. Maybe I don't, actually. What if the Dutch reclaimed Doggerland? I love how it says reclaimed. I refuse to believe for the longest time that Doggerland was a thing. Like, I don't know who would name an island Doggerland. It just sounds too fantastical. Is this where the dogs go when they run away? Even though that's kind of depressing, actually. But this is actually a thing that existed not that long ago during the Ice Age, especially because the North Sea is very low sea level. Probably wasn't this big. It was probably a bit smaller. Well, especially when sea levels rose a bit. But it could have been something the Dutch could have colonized, or the Vikings, maybe the British. Maybe this is what Atlantis was the entire time. That would make a whole lot more sense if, like, humans were out here building civilizations. Have we checked Doggerland for Atlantis? And alt history, where instead of GTA Definitive Edition, Rockstar releases what we all want. Then again, would it be bad? I'm afraid it would be just as bad, maybe. I don't know. Grand Theft Auto 6 trailer. Oh man, if I could just see one frame of that. 2024? Come on, bro. It's been 8 years since GTA 5. The rumors are it's going to Vice City. Actually, it probably is, now that I think about it. The solar system, a few centuries into the future. So on most of the inner rock planets, we have the UN of Earth. We have some sort of organization that has colonized Venus and Mercury. Of course, we still have our own home planet, but there's some Luna fleets around. I don't know how we got colonies in Venus. Venus would be pretty hard to get colonies on, I'm assuming. But then there's also the Martian Federation. Are these guys some sort of alien species? Or were they humans that now identify just as Martians? They don't like Earthlings anymore, even though we still have the same biology or something. I guess the lore behind this scenario is that humans have colonized just about every place they can in our own solar system. But in the home base, the place that resupplies all the colonies, it just got hit by an asteroid, so it's significantly weaker. So every place outside of Earth has splintered off and decided to do their own thing. There's the Jupiter and Saturn fleets. Sure, they probably have a lot of things on the moons. Oh yeah, this is exactly telling us what's going on the moons. Oh, the Martians have taken over Eros. Martian Mandate, I see. This is like a little war of colonies happening over here. Oh, this is definitely one of those battleground planets I can see. Then there's Saturn. Saturn is fully under control of one fleet, I guess. Uranus as well, under the Commonwealth of Outer Moons. And nobody's really on Neptune. I like that, because that's like a little small detail that, yeah, like, it's kind of far out there. Are we really going to worry too much about that? But what about Pluto? If the United States just bought the British Isles, or basically if the British Isles were states a part of the United States. So we've just added six new places. We have the state of the Commonwealth of England, the state of Wales, Republic of Scotland, Republic of Ireland, state of wow, I'm surprised they got their own thing. And Man. Wait, is this the Isle of Man? What about Sealand? I feel like Sealand should be a part of the states as well. We gotta take that little oil rig over. Hey, I'm okay with this. Are they okay with this? I wonder. Something tells me they probably aren't much of a fan, but this would be fun. It could be like the other Hawaii. Like, instead of going to the Pacific to have a nice vacation, we can go to the Atlantic and never see the sun for 360 days. Also, it's also raining, so I'm not sure how good of a vacation spot it could be. Just trying to look at the bright side. And big thanks to the Christmas patrons.
Aryan After Hours.
Drew's Arab Sugar Daddy.
What are you doing, Step Drew?
Why am I doing this?
This is Gabe.
Stormtrooper 501.
Rye the Pie.
Mine Brothers 999
Nemo X2. Shiki. Blore.
Max Majestic
Cooper.
Unicorn.
Luxemburg Lover.
Ivan Lima.
I Love Marks.
Drew's Argentinian Grandpa.
Dalton D.
Cybernetic Ghost of Christmas
Bring
Past
Bring Back
from
Poland
the future.
Barnsky W.
And for His Excellency,
King Corey.